We are now entering the modeling phase. Let's switch back to the IPython notebook. To recall briefly, we had chosen person 1 as B and person 2 as F, and we are going to classify them according to their location patterns. We did a final sanity check to ensure that the features chosen actually seem to have discriminating power. At this point, let's run this piece of code. What it does is it fills an array named classification events with the events of person B and person F. We are now going to split the data in a training set and a test set. In this case, we are going to use 60% of the data on training and 40% on test. Let's go ahead and do that first. At this point, we have split the data into training and test sets. We are using a large portion of the data for testing, as we will be illustrating several validation metrics on the test data. Just as a sanity check, we want to plot our features within our training data. Once you have run the above code, you should get histograms for the distribution of different distances at a certain time for each person. Remember, we wanted to make 3 different classifiers. To do so, we have now split our data set into the training and the test set. We also asked a quick question: are the features different enough in the training data set? We validated that again by looking at the histogram of the different features. So now we are ready to run the 3 classification models. Let's get back to the IPython notebook again. In this part of the code, we are setting up the 3 models for our classification problems. We are using the scikit-learn's logistic regression, support vector classifier, and the random forest classifier. This method here simply returns the model that we want to train. So now let's run this code. After you're done with defining the 3 models, let's simply build the models. It's as simple as this one line of code. Let's run it. And there you have it. We have the models built. In the following videos, we will use some of scikit-learn's built-in model validation metrics to give us the performance of these models. Before that, let us define some of the quantities we might want to look at when evaluating the performance of classifiers.